In this example, we're trying to find our five-number summary here for this set of data. So we want to start by filling out the two easiest ones, which would be our minimum and our maximum. So in this data set, to find the minimum, that means the smallest number in the data set. And if we look here, we can see that our data is in order from least to greatest, which makes our job way, way easier. So that the minimum is the smallest number in the data set. As we can see here, that number is 2. And then to find the maximum, that's going to be the opposite, which is going to be our largest number in the data set, which, as we can see here, is obviously 5. So if I take this, I'm just going to put 5 for my maximum. Next, to find my median, I'm going to go there because that's the number in the middle, which is the next easiest thing to find. But I need to know how many numbers I have in my data set. And here I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 numbers in my data set. So if I count, or if I divide, I'm sorry, 10 divided by 2 would give me 5, which means I want to count 5 from either side. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2 is where that divides. And then on this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So really I want the number that's right between 2 and 3. Now, some of you may be able to do this in your head, but if not, that's okay. We just want to take 2 plus 3, and let me move it over here, which we all know is 5, okay? But then I want to take that 5, and we want to divide it by 2. And I can't get my computer to work here, so we're going to divide that by 2. That does come out to be a decimal. So you can either leave it as 5 over 2, or you may want to write it as a decimal, 2.5. It's going to depend on what your teacher wants. I'm going to use 2.5. So that's going to become my median. And as you can see here, the 2 and the 3 are not included as part of that median. So we're going to use those numbers when we try to find our lower and our upper quartiles. So my upper quartile, or I'm sorry, my lower quartile is going to be on the lower half, the smaller numbers that I have. And in this case, all of my numbers are the same. But we're still looking for the number in the middle, so I'm still going to circle it, even though it's not going to matter. My lower quartile is obviously going to be 2. So my lower quartile and my minimum here are the same, and that's okay. For my upper quartile, again, we want the number directly in the middle, and out of 5 numbers, that would give me the third number would be my upper quartile, directly in the middle. It kind of splits that data in half. So 4 is my upper quartile. And that's how you find your five-number summary.